When it comes to screening resumes, do you sometimes feel like you're just kind of winging it? Do you feel like you're going through the process, but you're not even quite sure if you're doing it correctly? And when it comes down to sifting through all those resumes, do you feel like you may be missing out on that perfect person because you're not quite sure what you're doing? I think what every business leader wants, correct me if I'm wrong, is to be able to go through the entire recruiting process without having to do it again in another 90 days or within 90 days. Am I right? And what we truly desire is to find that right person easily and effectively. If this sounds like what you're searching for, keep watching. I'm going to share three secrets on how to find that diamond in the rough. Hey, and if you want to be in the know of every time I publish a new video, just hit that little subscribe button below this video and the notification bell right beside it, and you'll be notified. Over the course of my career, 23 years as of the date of this published video, I have screened tens of thousands of resumes, both through artificial intelligence and manually. And I can tell you that there are some great ways to screen a resume and some not so great ways to screen a resume. The very first mistake that people do when they are screening resumes is treating the candidate like a piece of paper. So what exactly do I mean by this? Did you know that the average length of time it takes a recruiter to screen a resume is approximately 7 seconds? That is a stat that has been pretty consistent for the entire course of my career. Like back in the early 90s, I was hearing that 7 second average for a recruiter to screen a resume. So what gets done in 7 seconds? How much do you actually absorb in 7 seconds? Do you think in 7 seconds, an informed decision can be made about a candidate? Now, remember, this is an average. So sometimes recruiters will take 1 to 2 seconds to go through a resume. And sometimes they'll take a little bit longer. The average is 7 seconds. There really truly are only a few reasons why you would sift through a resume so quickly. Number one would be they obviously applied for the wrong position. Number two, they didn't meet the minimum qualifications. That's what I like to do. I just like to quickly go through the resume to see, okay, do they have the minimum qualifications? Because you don't want to waste your time on that. Or number three, they didn't follow basic instructions. Those are generally the main reasons why you would sift through a resume so quickly. But there isn't a large percentage of people that apply for a position that fall under those categories. Most people who are applying for the position want that position and they meet those qualifications and they are worth spending more than 7 seconds on. So when I say the number one mistake is treating a candidate like a piece of paper, it's exactly what I mean. Look at that piece of paper that you just received, that cover letter, resume, any supporting documentation as the person. Not as black and white sheet of ink. And when you do that, you're going to start to learn a little bit more about that person. When you read their cover letter, you're going to see what kind of personality they have. When you go through their resume, you're going to see how much effort they put into this role and how much they really want to be a part of your organization. And all the supporting documentation, what kind of story are they telling you before you even meet them? All right, number two. The second mistake is a lot of recruiters, anybody who is going through the process of screening resumes, sees a job hopper, somebody with short-lived jobs, and they immediately screen them out. Don't do this. This is an antiquated way of thinking, and this type of thinking needs to be tossed out of your screening process. And guess what? If you're doing a screening of a resume and their credentials look good, their cover letter is great, but they've just had one too many jobs for your liking or two too many jobs for your liking, You can always ask them in the preliminary screening why they job hopped. Why would you throw them out? They could be an amazing candidate. Just get them to that next step to find out why. One thing that has always been true through every generation is people want to grow. They want to grow. They want to get to that next level, whether it be lateral or through promotion, but not every company can offer that. And in the old ways, people would stay with a company forever because it looked good and they had those hopes and dreams of eventually getting into that supervisor or manager role. In today's age, everything is so much quicker. The newer generations want things done now. They're used to technology, giving them what they want in a nanosecond. They don't want to have to wait to get to that next level when they feel they're ready now. So they will go search for a new job that can give them what they desire. And what I have to say about that is good for them. They are realizing what they want and they're going out and they are getting it. I had this client who couldn't keep employees for more than 3 to 5 years. These were professional employees, usually would come into the organization as fresh grads, and they would stick around for 3 to 5 years. But this organization was such a small organization that they didn't have that upward movement. They couldn't offer that to their employees. They had a lot of lateral growth, but nothing upwards. And that caused them to lose some really great employees after about the 3 to 5 year mark. Those employees who left that organization were great employees. They just wanted something more. So they're going to move on to another organization and be a great employee at that new organization where they get to meet those intrinsic needs that they have. And then maybe in another 3 to 5 years, they want to grow again and they're going to go find another job. So their resume is going to look like a job hopper, but it's not bad. They are actually great employees and they probably have fantastic references. It's the company that couldn't serve their needs, not they couldn't serve their company's needs. So again, back to my earlier point, short-lived jobs can be asked about in a pre-screen. Just go ahead and ask them. They'll let you know what happened. So far with these two mistakes that I've shared with you, do you feel like maybe you have been going through the resume screening process incorrectly? Let me know in the comments what your process has been up to now. The third and final mistake that I'm going to share with you is using AI to do the resume screening for you. Artificial intelligence, known in the resume screening world as applicant tracking systems, there is a place for them and they can be quite useful, but not usually in a small business if you're not hiring large amounts of positions. If you're only hiring 1, 2, 3, up to maybe 5 positions, you can do the resume screening on your own. The thing with ATSs, applicant tracking systems, is they're designed to search for keywords. And so when an applicant applies for a role, that ATS system will just boop, 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 look for those keywords and then spit it either to the yes pile or spit it to the no pile. And now you are going to take that shortlisted list of resumes that met all your keywords and you're going to move forward with it. And that is how you could be losing out on a diamond in the rough. Think about it like this. When someone's applying for a position, they're not professional resume writers. They are professionals or experienced or qualified in the position that they're applying for. And not everybody knows how to throw the resume up online to do a keyword search to make sure that it fits that role. Not everybody knows can afford to hire a professional resume writer to find a job. They're out of a job. They might not have that extra $100 to get somebody to resume write for them. So they're just going by what they know. okay, I need to put together a resume, I need to put together a cover letter, and I'm going to submit the best way I know how. And guess what? That ATS might just kick them to the wayside because they didn't have those proper keywords in that system. You're a small company, you don't need to spend the money on an ATS. If you want extra help because you don't have the time to do all the resume screening, I would more advise to hire a virtual assistant. Teach them exactly what you're looking for. Make sure they follow your process to a T. But when a human is searching for a human, you're going to get much better results and you are going to find that diamond in the rough. Are you ready to start screening resumes the better way? Give me a heck yeah down in the comments if you are. I would be grateful if you could give me a like, little thumbs up down below this video. If you enjoyed this content, it will help me grow my YouTube channel so I can continue bringing valuable content to you as a viewer. And if you didn't do this at the beginning of the video, please ensure that you hit that subscribe button and the little notification bell right beside it so that you can be notified of future HR videos that I release. As I'm sure you know, there are many aspects to human resources, not just screening resumes. And if you're a small business and you're looking for a little extra help on what all those aspects are, you can download my free small business guide to human resources. The link is in the description below beside free small business guide to human resources. And if you liked this video, you're probably going to like two other videos that I have released. One is on hiring confidently, and the other one is on reference checking. Good luck with everything. Thanks so much for watching.